Buenos días. Es el viernes, son las 12. Hello, everyone. It's 12 o'clock and it's Friday, so it's time for our third and final CNED Spanish of this week, broadcasting every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 12. As the usual reminders about other programs going on, we have our community French happening on Tuesday and Thursday mornings at 8:30 a.m. Eastern Time. And we also have our kids in Spanish and French programs happening every day. The kids Spanish is happening every day at 3:30, and our kids French is was at 3 o'clock, but we are slowly moving it onto a different schedule, likely to be Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday at 10 a.m. But we will have confirmation of that schedule up shortly, so you'll know when to tune in. So look out for updates on that. A couple other reminders, the August class schedule is now posted. So if you're looking to join an online class in August, all the options are up on the website if you'd like to take a look. Also, another brand new thing as of today, we are launching a referral program for Rola. So if you refer someone else to our school, if you're a current student, then both you and the person you referred can get 10% off of your next registration. So it basically, we want to kind of encourage people to keep referring. It's something that was already happening, but we thought it'd be great to have a program to basically reward people for doing what they're already doing and helping to grow our language community by referring people that they know. So that program is now live as of today. So you can look on our registration form page, and then there's a little button if you want to get access to the discount code if you've been referred as a new student. And last reminder is to please like, comment, and share on the videos we have going live on Facebook here, so we know what you're enjoying and what any suggestions you have about what you'd like to learn. We're happy to listen. We also have the virtual suggestion box on our website on the Facebook Live page, so you're welcome to leave us some comments and ideas there too. And while you check out the all the videos are posted are up there on the website along with the worksheets that go to accompany the videos to give you a little bit of extra practice along with them. So there's a lot of stuff for us to check out on our website as well. So without further ado, I'm gonna get into the lesson for today. It's a kind of a grammar verb centered lesson. We're gonna be doing we've looked at it in some different videos separately about some different verbs that fall into this category. I wanted to do one to kind of help group them all together to help see how the dots are connecting. And so we're gonna be looking at verbs that have a irregular form just in the yo, so just in the I form. So again, we've seen a lot of these different kinds of verbs in the past in my different videos. So I've done videos about verbs that are E to IE, stem changes, or E to I, or O to UE. So we have seen these kind of verbs in some other videos, but this video is specifically focused on verbs from some different categories, but they all share this same category as having the irregular yo conjugation. So it's kind of going to be a bit of a review of some different things we've seen across different videos. So let's get into it. Bueno. Okay, so we're going to, as I said, we're going to be looking at this specific group of verbs, of verbs where the yo form is kind of extra special. So we have to learn it a little bit separately because it doesn't follow the normal pattern. So we're gonna look through and see some of the most common verbs that fall into this category. Now there's gonna be many verbs that fall into this category, but we're here just gonna focus on some of the most common and most useful ones for you. So, and then we'll of course do a little bit of practice together before I post an additional exercise on the website to get even more practice. So first we're gonna look at the verb dar, which is the verb to give. So while all the other forms are pretty regular, the one we're gonna focus on here is for the yo form. And so por favor, repiten después de mí, please repeat this after me to help help you to learn them and also help make sure that your pronunciation is good. Yo doy. Yo doy. Just for the sake of it, we'll get through the rest of the conjugations too. Again, just to help reinforce in your memory about the conjugations for this particular verb, dar to give. So yo doy. Tú das. Él, ella, usted da. Nosotros damos. Vosotros dais. Ellos, ellas, ustedes dan. Okay, so that's the verb dar, to give. Next, we have the verb hacer, which I did another video that's specifically focused on this verb only. So if you want to take a look at that video to get a little bit more in depth with hacer, you're totally welcome to do that. So just to come back to the conjugation, again, we'll focus in on the irregular yo. In this case, it's yo. Hago. Yo hago. And we'll go through the rest of the conjugations again just to help reinforce with our memory. Tú haces. Él, ella, usted hace. Nosotros hacemos. Vosotros hacéis. Ellos, ellas, ustedes hacen. Next, we have the verb ver, to see. Yo veo. Yo veo. Tú ves. Él, ella, usted ve. Nosotros vemos. Vosotros veis. Ellos, ellas, ustedes ven. Next, we have the verb caber. This one is a little bit less common, but we could still use it pretty frequently. Caber is the verb to fit, as in something fits like inside something else, maybe. So we have for the yo, we have yo quepo. Yo quepo. This one is extra irregular because we have the C changing to the Q-U-E. Yo quepo. And then there's the P also, so again, completely irregular. Tú cabes. Él, ella, usted cabe. Nosotros cabemos. Vosotros cabéis. Ellos, ellas, ustedes caben. Make sure when you're pronouncing that you're putting that stress on the right part, on the second to last vowel, not the last vowel. So we don't say caben, but we say caben. Okay, so make sure that our stress is on the right place. Next, we have a group of kind of verbs that fit together in this category because they're ones that all have the go form as the ending for the yo. So that's why we've grouped them together to help you to learn them as a group. So we have first poner, which is to put or to place something in Spanish. Yo pongo. Yo pongo. Tú pones. Él, ella, usted pone. Nosotros ponemos. Vosotros ponéis. Ellos, ellas, ustedes ponen. Again, hope you're repeating after me. And again, remember, ponen, not ponen, but ponen. Okay, on to salir. Salir to go out. Yo salgo. Yo salgo. Tú sales. Él, ella, usted sale. Nosotros salimos. Vosotros salís. Ellos, ellas, ustedes salen. And just to drive the point home again for the yo, it was salgo, salgo. Okay, on to valer. Valer means to be worth, as in to be worth like a certain amount of money potentially, or it can be a little bit more figurative, like something is worth the trouble or worth the bother. Now, this is something where most likely you're not going to use this one in yo, because it must, in general, we don't say like I'm worth a certain amount of something. So we'll be using it mostly just in the third person. We're talking about like this thing is worth or those things are worth. So we're usually just choosing between vale and valen. But just for this, the purpose of going through and including this in this category of go verbs, we have the other forms and we're going to practice. So yo valgo. Yo valgo. Tú vales. Él, ella, usted vale. Nosotros valemos. Vosotros valéis. Ellos, ellas, ustedes valen. Next, on to traer, which means to bring, like bring something with you. Yo traigo. Yo traigo. Tú traes. Ella, él, ella, usted trae. Nosotros traemos. Vosotros traéis. Ellos, ellas, ustedes traen. This one, I think the most challenging part is actually the pronunciation of the A and E together, with the A and E, traes. So make sure you're pronouncing them kind of separately, but it doesn't have to be like super separate, like traes, but just to make sure that the letters sound distinct. Okay, last one in this group, we have suponer, which is to suppose. Or like, for example, if you're trying to say like, if someone asks you a question and you're like, I guess so, this is where you would use suponer in Spanish. So, yo supongo. Yo supongo. And you can see with this one, because it has poner in it, it follows the same as poner, which we learned just a minute ago. So, tú supones. Él, ella, usted supone. Nosotros suponemos. Vosotros suponéis. Ellos, ellas, ustedes suponen. Muy bien. So that's, those are the go. Now we're on to our last group, which is the ones that end with the Z, C, O. This one is another kind of special quirk of the verbs that fit into this category, where the yo, instead of being a go, like the last category we saw, is going to be with the zeta seo. So we'll hear some examples how this sounds. So first one we have agradecer is the verb to thank. For example, we say like, I thank you for this, okay? So yo agradezco, agradezco. So remember with the zeta, like I've mentioned in many previous videos, that with this letter, the letter Z in Spanish, that it's not Z like English, but we can have two options that we can pronounce it. We can say it like an S sound, like most Spanish speakers do around the world. Or if you are from Spain, they pronounce the Z in a specific way. It sounds more like a TH in English. So again, if I'm from a kind of around Spanish speaking world, I'm most likely I'm gonna say agradezco. But if I'm from Spain, I'd say agradezco. Okay, so it's a different pronunciation. Me, I say agradezco with the S sound, okay? So just make sure that you're not saying a Z sound like English, agradezco. That doesn't exist in Spanish. Agradezco. Okay, now for tú, tú agradeces. Él, ella, usted agradece. Nosotros agradecemos. Vosotros agradecéis. Ellos, ellas, ustedes agradecen. Remembering, second to last vowels where you put the stress. Okay, on to parecer, which means to seem. It's also one is also very useful. Yo parezco. Yo parezco. Tú pareces. Él, ella, usted parece. Nosotros parecemos. Vosotros parecéis. Ellos, ellas, ustedes parecen. Okay, on to conducir. We have just two more to go before we finish up this page. Conducir, to drive. Yo conduzco. Yo conduzco. Tú conduces. Él, ella, usted conduce. Nosotros conducimos. Vosotros conducís. Ellos, ellas, ustedes conducen. And you may also be familiar with the verb manejar. Manejar is a synonym for conducir. They both mean to drive. Okay, last verb here. We have traducir, to translate. Yo traduzco. Yo traduzco. Tú traduces. Él, ella, usted traduce. Nosotros traducimos. Vosotros traducís. Ellos, ellas, ustedes traducen. Muy bien. So we're just going to review these quickly. We're just going to do the yo form together before we get to our practice exercise where you can see how well you recall these conjugations. Okay? So again, we're just going to go through with the yos. So por favor, repiten después de mí. Please repeat after me. And we can do this quick review of all this information that we've just learned. So we have for dar, yo doy. Hacer, yo hago. Ver, yo veo. Caber, yo quepo. Poner, yo pongo. Salir, yo salgo. Valer, yo valgo. Traer, yo traigo. Suponer, yo supongo. Agradecer, yo agradezco. Parecer, yo parezco. Conducir, yo conduzco. Traducir, yo traduzco. Muy bien. I hope you remember some, at least some of those, so we can do our practice, because we're going to do essentially a quick quiz on some of these important verbs we just learned. See if you can remember the conjugation. So you're welcome to put your responses in the comments to let me know if what are the conjugations that you can remember. In the meantime, I'll fill out the chart up here, but see if you can test yourself and not try to look back at the material from before. Okay, muy bien. So we're going to start with dar, to give. So if you remember, first, the all important yo conjugation that goes with dar. Okay, so yo, this is our most important one where we've learned here, because again, as this lesson focused on the yo forms, yo doy, okay, I give, yo doy. And then we go on to the regular ones. So tú, das. Él, ella, usted, da. Nosotros, nosotras, damos. Vosotros, vosotras, dais. And ellos, ellas, ustedes, dan. Muy bien. That's one verb down. I think we have two to go. Two or three. Uno, dos, tres. Sorry, three to go. Okay, on to the verb traducir, to translate. Traducir. This one's going to fit into, if you remember from the last group of verbs that we just did. So, we're going to start with yo, traduzco, with that Z. Again, that was the focus of that last group of verbs, the ones that have the Z, C, O in the ending. So, yo traduzco. Okay, next one on to tú. Tú, regular. Traduces, tú traduces, you translate. Él, ella, usted, traduce. He, she, you formal. Nosotros, nosotras, traducimos. Remember to put that stress when you're speaking on the E, the second to last vowel. Traducimos. Okay. Vosotros, vosotras, traducís. So we have the accent right there. Traducís, and it's normal, a regular conjugation there. Ellos, ellas, ustedes, traducen. Again, I think the toughest part on these ones is to remember to put the stress. These are in terms of the errors I most often hear with my students, especially not the conjugation, it's the pronunciation of these ones. They put the stress at the end and say traducen, but it should be traducen. Okay, traducen. They translate. Muy bien. Okay, dos down and dos to go. We're on to traer, to bring. If you can remember which group this one fit into for traer. Y yo. Yo traigo for the yo form. Traigo, así, I bring. Tú, onto the regular, tú traes. Él, usted, trae. Nosotros, traemos. Again, easy because it's regular. Vosotros, trae. Ace. And last one, ellos, ustedes, traen. Muy bien. Okay, last verb to go before we wrap up our Friday community Spanish. We have the verb salir, which is kind of like a friend, I think, of traer in a sense, and you'll see what I mean in a second if you can remember what the conjugation was for yo. Yo salgo for yo, I leave, I go out. Tú, regular, sales, not sales, sales. Él, ella, usted, sale. Nosotros, nosotras, salemos. Ah, perdón, salimos, sorry, salimos. Vosotros, vosotras, salís. And the last one, ellos, ellas, ustedes, salen. Muy bien. Okay, well, that about wraps up our practice for today on that. So just keep in mind these verbs. Again, many of them are ones that we use a lot in our everyday language. So the more you have an opportunity to use them, the more you're likely to remember these irregulars. And I know there is kind of a long list, but at least there's some kind of helpful groups we can put the verbs into to help us to keep them organized in our mind about which ones end with go, which ones end with they say that, say all, and what other kind of patterns that we have. So I definitely encourage you to keep practicing, keep using these in your everyday conversation. And in addition to checking out the extra exercise, I'm gonna post on the website so you can get a little bit more practice with these types of verbs. But other than that, have a good weekend, and I will see you next on Monday for our next Community Spanish on Monday at 12. Gracias y adiós.